Good morning, friends, and a very happy Holi to everyone. Today we are going to talk about the theory of unimolecular reactions. So this theory has been proposed by Lindemann. So this is a Lindemann theory. So what happens here? So a molecule A collides with another molecule of A. So what happens? So some of the A molecules gets energized or gets activated, and some remains in the ground state. So there is a collision between the molecules of A to form some activated A species as well as some non-activated species. So this step is the energization step, which is and K1 is the rate constant for the energization state. Okay. So what happens now? Then what happens? A star before formation of the product from the A star species, there is a deactivation step. Why this happens? Because there is a time lag between this energization step and this decomposition step. That means there is a time lag between the formation of A star from A and the formation of product from A star. And due to this time lag, this A star molecules get de-energized when it collides with some unactivated A molecules to form the reactant again. So this is the deactivation step, and the rate constant is K minus 1. And the rate constant for the decomposition step is K2. Okay. So here A star has a transient appearance in this reaction. So we can apply steady state approximation to A star. That means the rate of formation of A star is equal to rate of decomposition of A star. So how to write the rate of formation of A star? So the rate of formation of A star is nothing but K1 into A square. And the rate of decomposition of A star is, so A star gets decomposed in two steps. Like one is the deactivation step and one is the decomposition step. So it is K inverse 1 A star A plus K2 A star. Okay. So from here we can get the concentration of A star as K1 A square by K2 plus K inverse A. So what is the rate of the reaction, or what is the rate of product formation? The rate of product formation is K2 A star. So it depends upon the A star, and the following rate constant is K2. So just putting the value of A star here, from here we are putting the A star value, we are getting rate is equal to K1 K2 A square by K2 plus K inverse 1 A. So this formula you have to memorize. So this is an important formula. Now comes to special cases at a high pressure and at a low pressure. What will be the case? So what happens at high pressure or at high concentration? The rate of deactivation is higher, because at high pressure the activated molecules undergoes rapid collision with the unactivated molecules to get back the reactants. So this deactivation step takes place when the pressure is high. So K inverse 1 A is very greater than K2. That is, the rate of deactivation is very greater than the rate of product formation. So just putting here, we are taking this K inverse A is very greater than K2. So we are neglecting this K2 value. So we are getting rate is K1 K2 by K inverse into A. So it follows a first order kinetics when the pressure or concentration is high. Now come at low pressure and low concentration. So what I mean here, at low pressure or low concentration, the rate of product formation is higher than rate of deactivation. So for the rate constant of deactivation is K inverse A. So K2 is very greater than K inverse A. So we are neglecting K inverse A term. So we will get rate is equal to K1 A square. So it follows a second order kinetics when the concentration or the pressure is low. So experimentally, for a unimolecular reaction, the rate is given as K unimolecular into A, where K unimolecular, K uni is the unimolecular rate constant. This is the experimental. So if we compare this, if we compare this one with our theoretical rate, so what we are getting, K uni is equal to K1 K2 A by K2 plus K inverse A. So this thing, this formula, you have to memorize. Numericals come from this formula. Okay. Anyway, so just taking the reciprocal, we are getting 1 by K unimolecular is equal to K inverse 1 by K1 K2 plus 1 by K1 A. So here, this part is a constant. This part is constant. So if we plot 1 by K unimolecular versus 1 by A, then we will get a straight line with a slope 1 by K1 and intercept K inverse 1 by K1 K2. So numericals come from this formula. Just like they will give the consideration of A, and they will give the respective rate constant. They will give two consideration of A and two rate constant value. So from there, they will ask you to find the rate constant of the activation state, that is the energization state. So K1 is the rate constant of the activation state. So they will be asked to find this K1 value. So I will try to solve some numericals based on this theory of unimolecular reactions in the next video. So that's all for this video. And if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe our channel for being updated. Thank you.